This is not the story of the One. The One encompasses too much, crushing everything and making it the same. No. This is the story of the many, who are blessed with difference and rich in strangeness. This is the story of a family. Once upon a time, in the age of the Eternal Cylinder, there lived a family of little creatures called the Trebom. Trebom are not the strongest, nor the fastest, and they do not have sharp teeth. They would make easy prey for the terrible force that came to their planet. But Trebom are loyal and resourceful and very, very stubborn. It is with such a Trebom that our story begins. One clever little creature born into a cruel world who would be instrumental in bringing prosperity to its kind. Run, something inside him said, run! The great crushing thing, the great cylinder, had stopped. Perhaps it was safe here for a little while. How quickly it learned to use its legs and its trunk. But these things were not so much learned as they were remembered. Perhaps, the little Trebom thought, they were a gift from the strange voice it heard in its mind. That too was a kind of memory. Just when it was starting to get used to its legs, the food from the jumping creature gave it new ones. With the right substance as a catalyst, a Trebom can transform and adapt to many challenges. The Trebon was drawn to a bright light, or perhaps to the creature next to it. Except for the grass growing on the old one's head, they were very much alike. Surrounded by this light, the Trebon knew things it had not known before. It knew the older Trebon had carried this light for a long, long time. And it knew that now that responsibility had passed to the next generation. Yes. This young Trebon had to carry the light to those great towers in the distance. It could have stayed here to learn many old things, but the cylinder would not allow it. Run, the inner voice said, run! The towers would not stop the cylinder unless they were activated. The Trebon had to step on the symbol or the cylinder would not be stopped. The voice inside the Trebon's memories assured it that while the tower stood, the Trebon would be safe. The power of the eternal cylinder was contained for now. This relative tranquility gave the Trebon a chance to think about its family. Trebon are not meant to live alone, so where were the others? Our young friend had found an egg, a Trebon egg, with one of his siblings inside. The egg had been abandoned, but it could still be made to hatch. All that was needed was a source of heat. Thank you. It was hard for the Trebham to know what to do or where to go. But the friendly voice suggested this was not the right way. To find your path, it said, you must follow the beam of light that emanates from the tip of the tower and stay away from the deep waters where the old things dwell. Finding another Trebham was a cause for joy, but this new friend was not well. Deep inside the memories it had inherited, the Trebham found the answer. To recover, its friend needed a very specific substance which appeared as glittering clusters of crystal dust. This dust was not natural. Only a great Trebham could create it. And so it was on the achievements of previous generations that the newborn Trebham would have to rely. Luckily, it seemed a wise and powerful Trebom had passed through here some time ago. This door had been built for Trebom. It gave them hope that in this large and dangerous world, some places had been made for them. Somehow, this ancient statue transferred knowledge to the Trebom. It was as if a memory had been stored inside it, waiting for someone to absorb it. And as soon as this knowledge had entered their minds, the Trebom realized that there was a great library of information hidden away in the web of their memories. But why was the knowledge of a specific ingredient placed here in this Trebom made of stone? Inside the cave, the Trebom found a living elder. It had been waiting in this chamber for a long, long time. The elder told them it was happy to see some friends before the cylinder came. It said, "You are young, so you never knew the time when our people could shapeshift at will. We, Trebom, are inheritors of a vast tree of abilities. Abilities passed on to all future Trebom. But this power is being taken away. Beware the servants of the cylinder. They will seek to hurt you at every opportunity, and they have the power to rob you of your abilities. But if you persevere, one day you will find a way to protect yourselves from their evil light. Farewell, my brave friends. I fear I am too old and tired to join you. May you find a way to prosper in this time of struggles. It was not easy to leave the cave, but the Elder had urged them to go forward. Suddenly, they felt the weight of their many tasks. To find their Trebum siblings, to restore the powers their people had lost. And it all seemed a little daunting. But even when they are afraid, Trebum are stubborn. Cylinder resumed its destruction. Nothing could stop it forever. They needed to roll to safety, to find another tower to protect them quickly. The Trebum found themselves almost as lost as they had been in the beginning. But the voice and their memories comforted them. It was only natural to be confused, it said. They had been born into a strange, broken world, cut off from the history of their ancestors. Everyone was a little lost these days. What mattered was to keep going, to keep looking for answers, to keep carrying the light they held within them, the light that stopped the cylinder. In this strange, eerie temple, the Trebum felt something stir in their memories. There was a great power in this place. Something from the days when even the elders were young. Perhaps it could help them. In this strange, eerie temple, the Trebum felt something stir in their memories. There was a great power in this place. Something from the days when even the elders were young. Perhaps it could help them. Thank you. The Trebum were disoriented for a moment. Something new had entered their memories and they needed to make sense of it. It seemed to be a map. And on this map, a location had been marked. If they understood correctly, there was some manner of serpent, a guardian, a greater being of some kind, somehow linked to a safe haven. Could they find refuge there? Their ancestors must have created this map for a reason. What manner of strange beast lurked behind the cylinder? The Trebum were deeply unsettled by this new mystery. But though some part of them was curious, they were certain it would be best not to find out. As their fear faded, the Trebum started feeling weak and tired. With all the excitement and adventure, they'd neglected their most basic needs. The sound of an empty stomach reminded them that survival requires more than escaping from danger. You also have to eat. Luckily, one of the many gifts of the Trebum is the capacity to store food in their bodies. But they still need to digest it to gain the vital energy that gives them strength. And for such small creatures, they do require rather a lot of food. Fortunately, the savannah was rich in flora and fauna, which would satisfy their little bellies without necessarily triggering a mutation. The Trebon were excited by this discovery. This new mutation would allow them to extract water from ingredients that were otherwise quite dry. But the voice cautioned them to be careful. More water was useful, but this process would not extract any nutrients. They would have to use it carefully and wisely. The Trebon felt a great power flowing through this cave, but they were not afraid. The power felt familiar, even friendly. These glowing structures were the work of their ancestors. Thank you. Trapped on all sides by deep pools of poisonous gas, the Trebum needed to find a way to escape this monstrosity. Perhaps there was a way to use the creature's own weight to lower the bridge? One by one, the yellow light cruelly burned away the Trebum's abilities. The Elder had warned them about the evil light of the cylinder's servants. Now they knew what kind of creature to avoid. Thank you. When the Trebham stepped on the strange device, an ancient memory came back to them. A memory of long ago, when the cities of their people still stood, and the fight against the cylinder was not yet lost. In those days, a very smart Trebham had found a way of cheating the cylinder, of stealing a little bit of its power to absorb and to reshape. In this way, the Trebham could revive their fallen friends, or send others to a hidden place. And it was also by this device that a link had been forged, and a path had been opened to the voice that spoke within them. Fury. The voice in their memory spoke with great urgency. The Trebham had to be very careful now. The cylinder would lash out at the lad, but it would not let them run too far. To survive, they would have to stay in the eye of the storm. Thank you. As frightening and surprising as this enormous creature was, the Trebom felt a sense of relief to see it descend from the sky. This was a celestial being they'd been told to seek. Perhaps it held an answer to their troubles. As they approached the colossal creature, their optimism faded. It did not seem to like them at all. And now they realized what terrible danger they were in. If this creature guarded the way to some holy place, then that place must lie below it. And being so large, the creature most likely could not see what was in front of it or beneath it. So perhaps the size of the Trebom was an advantage after all. Perhaps they could reach the platform right under the serpent's head. Relieved at having bested the Guardian, the Trebum now found themselves seeking the help they had been promised. Who would answer their questions in this place? Even with the light, the maze was difficult to traverse. Was there some clue in the structures on the walls? Was the path of sand on the ground meant to help them? Perhaps others had walked in this place long ago and tried to leave a path for those who would one day follow them. Thank you. Encountering another elder was a happy moment. The Trebom asked how they might survive the cylinder, and the elder replied, "I can feel your fear, little ones. Ever since this cataclysm began, we have been seeking ways to stop it. But the cylinder is relentless and indestructible. It will consume everything in its path. So, perhaps what we need to do is go behind it. I have discovered a mutation that allows us to rise into the sky. You must seek a weeping tree from which grows a special fruit that floats as it becomes ripe. It is the key to the transformation I have undergone. With it, you can use geysers to float well above the cylinder's height. My only regret is that I have grown too old and weak to help you with this task. If you find any glimmer of hope on the other side, remember me. Farewell." Sadness and fear filled the Trebom's hearts as they left the Elder's cave. Their only path to salvation was full of uncertainty, and they could not forget the thing they had seen lurking behind the cylinder, casting a dark shadow over this glimpse of light.